So obviously you have those two big fans. You want to avoid those at all costs. So you always want to approach from the 3 and the 9 o'clock position. Best way to like look at it is when you see them when they land, you see doors open with tag lines. So just real quick, with tag, we're going to go over way more in depth with SCED, but it's important to iterate. When you're doing tag lines, there's no need to yank on the cable or on the rope or sit there and wait.
One more.
It's gonna be a cable that comes down. Do not, it will shock you. Okay, once it hits the ground, the static electricity will be dissipated.
Cut it and then we'll go straight into the light iteration with it, with the holding on the tagline.
How y'all did stay outside of the rotor disc until one of the crew members clears y'all in. Whenever y'all are approaching the aircraft, approach from the next. A little bit about our the Black Hawk. We can carry up to 6 to 8 ambulatory patients depending on the configuration and if we have the hurricane seats in the back, but each of the litter pans have 3 seats that we can put down for ambulatory patients. Head strap is a little bit shorter because you want the head to be elevated when we're on the cable.
So like damage to the neck or the back or any kind of lower posterior area, line board underneath them prior to putting them on the skeg cones. It's not necessary.
Let's start securing some roses here to the skeg cone. So
we'll grab this.
Like securing it like that? But then secure all of this so it's not flying around the rotor wash. Yeah. EH on so you can protect them from the wind and everything. But have it to around the bridge of. And then right there in the carabiner should look like this. 2 down and 2 up. And so this little bar right there. You got both of your cables up here.